Hello, my name is Thomas Zvulun and I'm the stage director for the new production of Faust here at the Jacob School of Music. Faust is basically a morality play about an aging old professor, Dr. Faustus, who reaches the end of his life and discovers that his life was wasted and his youth is gone and there is nothing he can do about it. He misses his youth, the times that he was young, and in his frustration he curses God and summons the devil. The devil appears and makes Faust an offer that he can't refuse. He tells Faust, "I will give you your youth back if you will give me your soul." Faust makes probably the most horrible mistake of his life and agrees, and this is where our tragedy starts to unfold.
We're not doing this typical where he becomes young in the same time period. In this one, we're starting in 2011, and he goes back to his own youth, which the director, Tomer, has specifically wanted that concept, that you don't ever desire to be young in the current time, but to go back.
I feel as though Faust has a lot of overarching themes that are applicable to really any time frame, you know, any era in history.
It can be done in any time period, but this time period is wonderfully relevant because we see an old man in an age of technology trying to reconnect with his youth and kind of paying the price for getting to do something that we all kind of wish we could but can't.
We took that single moment, the most important instant in the opera, the moment of transformation of Faust from an old aging man into a young Prince Charming. We took that moment and extended it to a transformation of the whole world. We start our show in 2011, and as Faust is transformed into a young man, the world goes back.
I can't just be myself in that time. I have to try to remember what, or try to think of what a man who had lived a full lifetime would do with the newfound youth.
She's a very innocent, naive girl. She's very invested in her family, most of whom have passed away. Her brother is a soldier who's gone to war, and she is a governess. So she's pretty much a good girl.
To actually play someone who is evil, you know, the root of all evil is an interesting thing. He's always got the upper hand. And it's a really interesting take on evil.
He has a lot of complexity that most tenor roles that I've sung before do not have. You know, I have to be an old man hunched over in the beginning, have to be a young man, you know, with strength and energy, and then slowly lose that but maintain the youth.
Tomer is a really specific and open-minded director.
Yeah, Tomer's a great guy, and I'm not just saying that because we haven't, you know, finished the show yet.
He can work with people on their own level.
It was wonderful for me to come in and work with someone who had a very clear vision of what he wanted to create.
I'm really excited to see how the show is going to go up. You know, he, with his Magic Flute last year, was a huge show, and I think this one's going to be the same thing from what I've seen of the set. So I really encourage people to come see it because it's always going to be a spectacle when he's directing something.
I'm very, very excited to be back at IU and to work once more with my friend and collaborator David Higgins. I'm also very, very happy and excited to be working with another David, with Maestro David Efron, who I find to be not only an exquisite musician with great taste and sensibility to dramatic storytelling, but also the most suitable person to take this young, excited cast that we have and bring it to the best of its musical and vocal abilities. We open on February 25th, on Friday, and have another performance on the 26th, Saturday. The following weekend, we'll have two more performances on March 4th and 5th, and I hope to see you in the audience.